The top military leaders in the U.S. face the press and make promises.
And we are the United States military, and we fully intend to successfully evacuate all American citizens who want to get out of Afghanistan. All American citizens who want to get out of Afghanistan. They are our priority number one.
But then these leaders admit they can only do that if the Taliban let them. And right now, there are widespread reports of people being denied access to the airport.
We don't have the capability to go out and collect up large numbers of people, Barb.
They say they are negotiating with the Taliban to allow Americans and credentialed Afghans to pass, but say the number of U.S. troops there means they can only focus on keeping the airport safe. And with another 2,000 people evacuated on Tuesday, there are still tens of thousands of U.S. citizens and Afghans who need to get out. How did this happen? The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff says no one saw this coming.
The time frame of a rapid collapse that was widely estimated and ranged from weeks to months and even years following our departure. There was nothing that I or anyone else saw that indicated a collapse of this army and this government in 11 days.
The consistent line from the Pentagon has been, this is not the time to look at what went wrong, but instead to focus on the mission. But with growing outrage from both Republicans and Democrats, it's likely congressional hearings could start as early as next week for what many are calling a humiliating, catastrophic failure. Patty Culhane, Al Jazeera at the Pentagon.